You have a style here. We've talked about it. It is rapid fire, sort of simple sentence after simple sentence, and I don't mean that in any derogatory way. It I'm sure has its roots, or you know, can still be called noir style. That kind of I don't have time to mess with anything left or right. We're just going straight ahead. So I did this. I went here. I smelled this. I was happy without the niceties of and or therefore or anything like
there's
that.
There's actually plenty of ands in there, Doctor, and the dialogue is differentiated and is full of commas and stops and pauses. This book is about the first 23 days of America in World War II. Mm-hmm. L.A. was an around-the-clock blackout riddled town during that time. Everybody was up constantly, war profiteering, manning searchlights, engaged in fabulous fistfights, devastating love affairs, and you have to move the story. I wanted people to read this book in fewer, longer increments so that they can live the obsession and that round-the-clock feel themselves. Mm-hmm. The same way I wrote it, the same way people really lived it at the time.
Mm-hmm. What I came away and what I was getting at with those short, that idea, is you have this juxtaposition of brutishness and eloquence. So we have this brutishness, the experiences that we're going through, a kind of a brutal language, a brutal voyage through language, as we're representing that experience. And then suddenly these arias of exposition where somebody will say something and it'll go on for a long paragraph and it is exquisitely eloquent and it makes such a counterpoint to the madness.
First of all, thank you. And that's the main point of the style. You have four brilliant protagonists, a woman and three men. They are constantly involved in the attribution of meaning. Mm-hmm. They are wild ideologues, passionately intellectual people. The style is brutal. The time was brutal. The stakes in Los Angeles were brutal with the internment of the Japanese and the imminent specter of Japanese sea and air attack. And you have these eloquent people thinking about their lives, placing themselves right at the heart in context of this wild time in our history.
I love those sequences. I really do liken them to arias. They suddenly stole everything from whatever was around them. They steal from all of that and they make something in that moment, if only that moment.
Yes, yeah. Dudley Smith, in the middle of all his double dealings, does his own treatise on what will happen in World War II and likens the Führer's end to the doomed lovers in Wagner's opera Tristan and Isolde. The world when the strings drop during the prelude.
You have a great line that sort of summarized this approach for me, and you called it, one of the characters just says in a line, Benzedrine and Shakespeare.
Yeah.
And there it was.
Yeah.
I thought that freneticism and that contemplative moment.
Yeah. That's Dudley Smith thinking, I am but mad north by northwest.
Yep.
When the wind is southerly, I know a hawk from a handsaw.
Well done. It there was also something, it was a little more prosaic, but it's Kay Lake, I think, saying this, where she says, the war was 2 days old. I consorted with suspect aliens and created public scenes. Pinch me. I could be home practicing Chopin.
Oh, yeah. This book is a historical romance at its heart. And as I said, the first month of World War II in Los Angeles wasn't all bad. As the character ruminates, those swabbies at Pearl didn't know what hit them. We could be next, so the party is on. Mm-hmm. There's four big party sequences in this book. Mm-hmm. So we get to go to the party.
Mm-hmm. And the party is a party. And it is more, not more intense because it's set against this background of there might be a submarine. There yeah. might be that thing that happened in you know, at Pearl Harbor. And I don't know what that does to people, but you do a good job of helping us imagine it.
I got to live the first month of World War II.
Okay.
In Los Angeles, writing this book. And that's in large part why I do it. It's a benign megalomania. I get to rewrite history to my own specification, or no one gets hurt.
Yeah.